H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to BA Demo. Before I start, let me introduce you myself. Well, my name is Shah. I've been working in IT for almost 16 years now. And most of the time, I've been working as business analyst and as a project manager. As far as my training experience goes, I have close to 7 years of experience as a business analyst trainer and as a project management trainer. So when it comes to project management, I teach CAPM and PMP certification. As far as my education goes, I'm an MBA graduate from San Jose State University, California. I do also hold PMP certification since July 2006. That's been more than 7 years now. I've been working as certified PMP-based project manager. And as of now, I'm based in San Diego. I work for a company called Qualcomm. It's a telecom company that I work for, and I work in the capacity of a project manager. Before we proceed, let me give you some information about the company. Well, we are based in Atlanta, Georgia, mainly. Of course, we do have offices at many different locations. We have a very good presence in North America, especially US and Canada. Also, we have presence in European and Asian countries too. As a matter of credibility, we are an e-verified business, and we provide worldwide services in IT training and IT consulting. Also, we provide almost all courses in IT. We really specialize in QA, BA, and project management. These are the different clients. We do business directly. So here you can see some very big clients like GE, AT&T, Dish Network, Wells Fargo, Verizon, Sony, Bank of America, Citigroup, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Home Depot, and so on. So well, in this demo session, so these are the different topics that will be covered. So we'll see who is a business analyst is. We'll see who qualifies for a BA. We'll understand roles and responsibility of a BA. We'll look into the course curriculum. We'll understand the career path of a BA. We'll do a job comparison between BA job and other jobs in IT. We'll look into the schedule of the training and some additional points. And at last, I would like to conduct question and answer session. So let's start with the question, who is a business analyst? So this is what the definition says. That is, a business analyst is one who acts as a liaison or mediator or bridge between business team and technical team. So let me elaborate on this. So what actually it means is, now let's say this is an IT department. So when I say IT department, we have two different group of people. Well, one group of people are called as business team, and the other group of people are called as technical team. So in this situation, what happens is you have a BA who acts as a mediator. That is, on one side, you have a business team, and on the other side, you have a technical team. So basically, a BA is one who acts as a mediator between business team and technical team. So being a mediator, what exactly he does, we'll see that in a few minutes from now. Now next, let's see the method of the training, how this training would be conducted. So what happens is, now let's say if I have to teach you a topic. So first what we do is, first I shall go through the theoretical part of the topic. Then I shall go through the practical aspect of it. So when I say practical, what happens is, I shall cover real-time projects from my side. So talking about some important topics, what we do is, I shall cover two projects from my side. Not only that, I will be making you work on real-time projects from your side. So basically it would be five projects from your side. So here, we're talking about seven projects by the time you complete the course. Not only that, every topic would be story-based. I strongly believe in this. That is, stories are really a very nice way to make you understand a subject. Stories will help you to remember the subject for a really long time. Not only that, I would like to emphasize a lot on IT slangs and jargons. This is something that makes you sound really seasoned professional. Next, we'll see who qualifies for a BA. A very common question what I get from beginners are, what background should one have to pursue BA as a profession? To answer this question, individual can come from any background. Background doesn't matter, but having a business background would be a big plus, but not compulsory. And moreover, computer degree is not at all required, as this is not a programming or technical based job. That is, no programming or coding is involved in BA profession. So individual having MBA degree can join this course. Individual having sales and marketing experience can join this course. Anybody from finance background can join this course. Let's say anybody from management background can join, or people from healthcare background can join this course. Next, let's see roles and responsibility of a BM. So like I told you before, for every topic, we have a story. Again, for this, I have a very nice story to tell you. But before going on to the story side of it, let me first walk you through the definition. So the definition says, a business analyst is responsible to gather requirements, detailed requirements, document requirements, and validate requirements in a format that is useful to business team and technical team. Let's see the story side of it. Just for fun, let's talk something outside IT. Let's talk about a restaurant, like a food restaurant. And let me play the role of a customer. So being a customer, so when I go to a restaurant, what happens? Quite obvious, a waiter would approach me. And a waiter would be very curious to know what I want to have for lunch, what I want to have for meal, what I want to have for dinner. So he would ask me a question saying, what you require? Now let's say this is me playing the role of a customer. So let's say I order for 2 pizza. Okay, let's say I order for 1 sandwich. Let's say I request extra cheese on the pizza. Let's say I request extra pepper in the sandwich. Now tell me, what is this in the box? Well, we can call this as my food need. We can call this as my food order. We can also call this as my requirement. In that case, what is a waiter trying to do here? So, well, we can say that the waiter is trying to gather my requirements. In the meantime, I have a question. I want you to think on it. That is, being a customer, so when I was orally explaining my requirements, when I was orally describing my requirements, what do you think? What a waiter does? So everybody might have observed a waiter carries a small little notepad, and that small little notepad will have 3 columns. So what he does is, in the first column, he would enter the food menu, that is in this case, pizza, that is in this case, sandwich. In the second column, he would enter the quantity, that is 2 and 1. In the third column, he would enter the comments, that is in this case, extra cheese and extra pepper. So what exactly is the waiter trying to do here? So well, the waiter is trying to organize my requirements. Organize because if you see here, he has put all the food menu in one column. He has put the quantity in another column. He has put the comments in the third column. So based on that, we say the waiter has organized my requirements. Now question comes, why the waiter has to organize? Well, the waiter organizes so that it is easy for the chef to understand. Okay. In the meantime, we have a word called as detail. So here the word detail and the word organize, they mean the same. So in that case, we can say that the waiter has detailed my requirements. Also, we can say the waiter has documented my requirements because this is a kind of a documentation in itself. I have a question I want you students to think on it. So that is, once a waiter gathers, once a waiter details, once a waiter documents, what does he do next? Have you ever seen a waiter repeats the order? Yes, he wants to cross-check. He wants to cross-confirm the requirement what he has taken is correct or not. That is, he's trying to validate. He's trying to cross-check the requirement what he has taken is correct or not. That is called as validation or validate. And after validation, he would hand over the requirement to the chef. And what a chef does is, the chef would prepare the food based on the requirements given by the waiter. And of course, later on, this food will be served to the customer. That's me in this case. So the surprise is, even the BA has to do something similar. So that is, being a business analyst, you would gather software requirements from the customer. You would detail the software requirements taken from the customer. You would document the software requirements. You would validate the software requirements. And after validation, you hand over the requirement to the developer. So this is where the developer would come into the picture. So what a developer does? The developer would prepare the software based on the requirements given by the BA. So here I would like to emphasize a little bit more on gathering of software requirements. So let me take up a story here. Now let's say we have a person by the name Sam. Now let's say Sam has opened a new travel agency. Now let's say he needs a website for the travel agency. So what would you do? So definitely he has to go to some IT company. Now let's say this is some IT company close to his place. Now let's say this is where I work as a BA. So what happens here? Sam would approach the company that is indirectly to me. So I being a BA, what's my job? My job is to gather information. So that is, I get in touch with Sam, I interact with Sam and understand his requirements and understand his needs. So for example, here, I would like to know from Sam what color the website should be. What are the different tabs Sam want on the website? And does he want to take the payments online? Does he want a login functionality? Does he want a chat customer support? Well, this is a very small format of gathering of software requirements. Once you have gathered, see the way the waiter has used a template of this kind. Being a business analyst, you'll be using a template called a use case template in order to detail. And that would call as a detailing of software requirements. And later on, you would document them. And later on, you would validate them. After validation, like I told you before, you hand over the requirement to the developer. And the developer would prepare the software based on the requirements given by the BA. So here, during the course, we will see different methods to gather software requirements. We'll see different types of requirements. Also, we'll see different ways to detail software requirements. Also, we'll see different documentation that you have to prepare. Also, we'll see different methods to validate. Well, I would call this as core part of the syllabus. Core part, an important part of the syllabus. Next, we'll see different modules that will be covered in this course. Being a business analysis course, business analysis will be the main module. Additionally, the company has added four more modules to the course in order to make you very competitive when compared to students coming from other institute. So that is project management based on PMP will be covered. This has many advantages. First of all, it helps the BA's interaction with the project manager. Secondly, it makes you qualify for BA project manager job. So that is, there are so many jobs outside in the job market which says we need a BA with project management skills, or which says we need a BA with project management knowledge, or job which says we need a BA who can assist a project manager. Also, software testing basics will be covered. This would be a very valuable add-on to your profile. Additionally, healthcare domain and finance domain will be covered to give you edge in job screening process. At this stage, I commonly face a question from students saying, should we pay the fees separately to all the five modules? Answer would be, you just pay the fees for BA. You just pay the fees for BA. So this additional four modules, what you have, it will be given for no cost. And we do this to help students get job quickly. Next, we'll look into the career path of a business analyst. Definitely, most of you might be having a question saying, if I start my career as a BA now, where will I see myself in next 5 years? Where will I see myself in next 10 years? So this career path should explain you that. So like I told you before, so business analysis would be covered, project management would be covered, software testing, healthcare domain and finance domain will be covered. So with this combination, definitely can apply for BA job, no doubt about it. Also, you'll be eligible to apply for BA project manager job, like I told you before. Also, you'll be eligible to apply for BA QA job. So whatever the first level of job is, next level would be project manager. After that would be program manager. After that would be portfolio manager. Let's say if you are ambitious, you can also make yourself into management. What do we get to see here? We see growth. So that's a good thing about this career path. You have growth. And also if you see throughout, it is all about manager. It is all about management. Like I told you before, this is not a technical job. It is more like a business. It is more like a management. It is more like a manager kind of a job. Also, if you see here, this is a good thing about our syllabus. See, by going through our syllabus, you will be eligible to apply for many different types of job. That makes job waiting process quite easy. Next, we'll do a job comparison between BA job and other jobs in IT. So this screenshot, what you see, this has been taken from Career Builder. So here, when I search for .NET developer job on Career Builder, I found 1,483. At the same time, when I search for Java developer job, I found 1,913. Good number. So when I search for SAP, it was quite disappointing. I just found 89 job. So when I search for BA, I found 9,953. The number is huge. Now let me justify, how come you have so many jobs in BA? Now let's say the project is to make a web portal for a bank. So you can make a web portal using Java technology. You can make a web portal using .NET technology, or let's say some X technology, which is expected in 2018. Now let's see a scenario when we use a Java technology. Now let's say in case of Java technology, in order to make this project, you need a project manager, you need a BA, you need a Java architect, you need a Java developer. Fine. Now let's see how the scenario would look when we use .NET technology. In case of .NET technology, we need a project manager, we need a BA, we need a .NET architect, we need a .NET developer. Fine. Now let's see the last scenario based on X technology, which is expected in 2018. In that case, you need a project manager, you need a BA again, you need an ex-architect, you need an ex-developer. So what do you see in common? You see project manager being common for all the project and also BA. So that is, so when you count all the BA job from all the project and all the technology, that's how the number comes up to be big. Next, let's look into the batch schedule. We have a very nice arrangement of timings. So we have three batches a day. So we have one in the morning, 10 a.m. EST, and we have one in the evening, 8 p.m. EST. We have one in the night, 10:30 p.m. EST. And the days would be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday for 10 a.m. And for 8 p.m., Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And 10:30 p.m., the same, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So the fun part about this is, all the three batches, what you see here, will run in parallel. So it means, let's say Tuesday, morning, 10 a.m., I teach your topic called as cost management as part of 10 a.m. batch. It means the same topic will be again repeated second time in a day at 8 p.m. EST. It means the topic will be again repeated third time in a day at 10:30 p.m. EST. That is, we teach you a topic three times a day. We teach you a topic three times a day. And we do this for sake of revision. We strongly believe in revision. I insist all the students to attend all the three batches. If not three, at least twice. I see some students, they come in the morning, they come in the evening. Some, they come in the morning and night. Some, they come in the evening and night. Always recommend to attend the training more than once. Also, this gives you the flexibility of the schedule. That is, one day can come in the morning, next day can come in the evening. Next day can come in the night. Let's say Friday night you have some plans, no problem, you can come in the morning. You can keep shifting the batches on daily basis. Anyways, the topic covered will be the same in all the three timings. Let me walk you through some additional points. The total duration of the course would be 2 months. Interview preparation help will be given after this 2 months of course. That will be again a separate set of classes. Job support will be given. So the condition is one should call me between 4 to 5 p.m. EST, Monday to Friday. Also, this would be a lifetime enrollment. So what it means is, now let's say once you're done with this 2 months of course, now let's say if you want to repeat this course, yes, you can repeat this course 100 times you want. It is just the first time what you pay the fees. The following time, you need not pay the fees. That is what called as lifetime enrollment. We will be starting the batch in a couple of days. If you're interested, kindly call this number for registration. I hope you like the demo session. Hope to see you in my regular classes. Thank you so much.